How are you guys doing? Welcome back to yet again a brand new video, boys. For today's video, we are actually going to be working underneath my car bonnet today because we are going to be servicing my car myself for the first time. For anybody who doesn't realise how big of a deal this is, right? I've only ever put in an air filter and that's about it. Alright, so here is the engine, the V8 twin turbo engine. Boy, look, if you pull this lever right here, it activates supersonic mode. So I never pull that. All my car needs, I believe, is an oil change. Obviously, I'm not qualified to do the lookovers, but I do actually have an... How loud are you, you fucking bitch? Oh my, am I gonna have to deal with your fucking fat ass the whole time? Alright then, boys, honestly, my car is about to have a pampering day. Honestly, we're gonna massage its underneath. So, obviously, right here, we've got all of the stuff we're gonna put in the car today. We've got an oil, we've got an oil filter, and we have got some premium screen wash. This is called, yo bro, you got something in your eye. And boys, this is the real shit. How do I know that? Because it says it on the bottle, the real shit. Next up, we've got the tools we're gonna be using. We've got a torque wrench, and then we've got like a socket kit. Last but not least, we have just got a bucket to catch all the oil, and we've got an oil bottle, which I've made sure nobody is gonna drink it or anything by saying, tasty oil. Nobody's gonna drink it now. Last year, my car actually got spoiled. Fam, this is how much I paid for it. 270 quid. So because I got a major service last year and they rinsed my bloody bank account out, like what the fuck? The only thing that I'm really gonna do in this service is what they do in an interim service, I believe it's called, which is an oil change and an oil filter change. So yeah, my baby is gonna be nice and lubed up so it can properly put down every bloody horsepower under the bonnet, which equates to 6 horsepower. Now, if I went to the same dealership that I usually go to, they would have charged me £130. The oil cost me £37.99. The oil filter cost me around £8, which equates to £45.99 for this service, and that gives me a saving of 84 quid and 1 pence. Fam, the amount of McDonald's I could have for that is absolutely crazy. Oh wait, we're in fucking lockdown, so I can't. So I am actually in need of an MOT. So, basically, in the MOT, I believe they check like your brake lines and stuff, and you know, make sure everything is in working order. I'm gonna do the service a bit, and then they can go and suck my ass and make sure everything's all good. The first thing that my car needed, which was out of the minor service or the interim service, was the battery. My battery has one bloody job, and it did not do it fucking nicely. Honestly, my car died so many times in this lockdown, so I literally just went online, ordered a battery. I was meant to install that in today's service, however, I did actually need to go on a drive, so I just installed it very, very quickly, like a week ago. Alright, so the first thing that we're going to start off with is the screen wash.
I'm defusing the bomb.
That one all done. Damn.
Fam, that was like defusing a bomb.
But yeah, the next thing we gotta do is jack the car up and get under the car. So, what I'm gonna do is the first step is to get under this car. Oh, oof. And I believe this is the oil pan. This is where all the oil is right now, I think at least. And yeah, we're gonna have to untighten this, put the bucket underneath it, and all the oil will drain out of there. Then, once it's all drained out, we can put the new bloody oil in. So let me get the fuck out of here. All right then, boys. I don't know if this is the right screw, but we're gonna check that under anyway. The oil pan, or oil bucket.
So the screw for the oil pan was actually very, very tight. It was tight, like a pussy. So I ended up using a brake bar, and a brake bar is so perfect for me because I have got noodle arms.
Got to be very careful now. Oh, there we go. Feels like my car just came on me. Boys, if we go into the car right now, you can see it's proper like dripping.
Okay, all right, boys. So here is my oil filter. While that is still draining, I'm gonna do the oil filter. We just need a little socket. I don't know if you can actually see that. Hold on. Right down there, this one. We're gonna need to unscrew that with one of our sockets and then we're gonna install it with this. The oil filter is like one of the main parts of the car. It filters out all the bitches, the bad bitches. Quite a tight fit down here. Got it. Got it. Literally, this is all I can move it right now. Alright, so what I've done is I've put a plastic bag just around it just so the oil don't go completely everywhere. I figured out how to get the oil filter off the actual bit. You just had to literally yank it off. But I'm gonna do quicker than what, man's? Because we're gonna about to install the new one. So inside here, I believe there should be a new O-ring or a new seal. Perfect. I believe that goes where that blue thing was. Hang on. There you go. New oil filter installed. That's what a brand new oil filter looks like. And this is what the old one looks like. Disgusting. It looks like bloody duck sauce that you get at the bloody Chinese. So now this should just basically slot back into it and then screw back in.
It's so fiddly, what the fuck?
Nice. Now let's hand tighten it down and then we can torque it down in a bit. Fuck it, now here we go again. Forgot about this bit. So, oil filter check. Look at it, right? Right, let's go into the car and let's tighten this screw up. Thread that in by hand first. And then, quickly wipe this. And what we can do is we can drag the oil pan out now. See all the dirty oil. That literally looks tasty. Fam, that looks like chocolate milk. Oh my God, that looks tasty. What the hell? Now all we need to do is put the oil in. Oh my God, look how like new the oil looks. It's like golden. Look how nice it looks. It looks like golden syrup. Boys, I look like a bloody lobster right now, Jesus. The car is now all good, right? I put in some more oil and I put in the correct amount, put in 3.5 litres. The dipstick is bang on. Correct, let me show you guys actually. Perfect, it's like in the middle. Now I did want to put it like a little bit higher than the middle, but it looks like it's running perfectly anyway. It's like one off the maximum. So yeah, that is all of the servicing complete, you know? Oil is now in the car, and honestly, boy, I drove my car for a little bit just to make sure that the you know oil was right and everything in the car was right. Not sure if it's like the placebo effect, but boy, this tuk-tuk felt like a bloody Bentley Continental GT. So smooth, honestly. So for this service, obviously we didn't change the air filter because the air filter is a performance air filter. We changed the oil filter, nice. Basically changed the battery and it is looking nice actually. My car literally would never start properly. It would do a slow crank. So it would sound like an old man. It would be like, now fam, the car literally just goes, so I'm very happy with how it is turned out, to be honest. I want to know from you guys, do you service your own car? You know, for my next service, it's going to be a bigger one. So it's going to be like a coolant change. It's going to be spark plug change. So I'm not 100% sure if next year I'm going to do that myself or have to pay somebody to do it. But I think if I've got the confidence now to do this, your boy's going to do it next year. Hopefully my car doesn't blow up by then, but the tuk-tuk, it's nice and fresh now. It's got fresh new oil.
So basically, unfortunately, that is the end of today's video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy watching me change the oil in my car, and obviously I was gonna fit the battery. It's quite boring to be honest, but very easy to do. But yeah, honestly, I would so recommend doing this. It saved me like 50 odd quid or even more than that. So yeah, I will be getting my MOT soon. So obviously all the checks that need to be made will be made by a proper dealership, and my MOTs are free. So now people were telling me about my tires. I do need new tires. This one's fine because it's actually a brand new one. But all my other ones actually do need changing. Like this one needs changing, back one needs changing, and also this one needs changing. I mean, I don't know if you guys can see my finger, but this is how much it goes in. So unfortunately, that is the end of today's video, guys. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. Subscribe if you are new, and follow me on Instagram at @_OtherStuff if you did enjoy and you want to go see behind the scenes and stuff. Anyway, guys, from me and my tuk-tuk, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you love faces in my next video.